you 50 cents, stranger. Before you start eating it.
Oh, sure. There you are.
Hey, what are you trying to pull?
What's the matter?
This coin no good. It's counterfeit.
That's a $20 gold piece. Where's my change?
Trying to pass phony money around here, huh? Sure, I'll give you your change.
Chuck's a little winded at the moment, ma'am. Maybe I should answer you. I don't see why a lady like you should care.
I happen to own this place. Is that sufficient reason?
I'd say that was plenty of reason, ma'am.
You tried to pass some phony money, Shannon.
Phony money? In my place?
A phony $20 gold piece.
Is that all the money you have?
That's all. A man has to eat, you know.
Well, if a man wants to eat, he'll be willing to work for it.
I'm willing.
Maybe I can find something for you to do. In advance on your wages. When things have cooled off a little bit, come back and see me. I'll be upstairs.
Thanks. You've hired yourself a hand, ma'am.
Shoulders.
Look, Bartell, this is my place and I hire who I like.
You're asking for trouble, Shannon.
Take your hand off my arm.
What happened to you? I thought you were supposed to be waiting for me here.
Buckskin threw a shoe.
Find out anything on your way in?
I heard you can buy United States government revenue stamps at 50 cents on the dollar in this town. Looks like your hunch about those counterfeiters was right. You still set on playing the pigeon?
Yeah, I've already had my feathers ruffled.
Better watch your step. What's my play?
See that bar across the street, Shannon's bar? Go over and see if you can't stir up some trouble.
Right.
You're new in town.
That's right.
Being a stranger here, I figure you got a right to be warned.
Warned? About what?
About playing up to Shannon.
You mean somebody wouldn't like it?
I wouldn't like it.
Shannon's a mighty pretty woman. Kind of hard for a man not to want to play up to her.
You got any more of that sour money you tried to pass?
Sour money?
Never mind the innocence. Let me see your pouch.
What pouch?
The boss said, let's see the pouch.
Hold it. Now, you're gonna dig out that pouch, he wanted to use a gun on you.
Hold up in broad daylight? Where's the law?
There's no law in this town. Come on. So you're a pusher. This is all phony stuff.
Takes an expert to know it.
You're looking at one. If you're smart, you won't waste your time working for Shannon.
Sounds interesting.
I've got an office up the street. Come in and see me.
Thanks. I will.
What can I do for you, stranger?
Well, I'm a federal officer, and I understand that there was a man in here today that was trying to pass some counterfeit money.
Might have been. I wouldn't know anything about it.
Well, why wouldn't you know? You're the bartender, aren't you?
I told you I didn't know anything about it. Now, look, if you want some information, you better go see the boss.
Where is this boss?
Upstairs. I'll go up.
No, that's all right. You just stay here and polish your glasses. I'll find the boss.
Not a thing, ma'am. Are you the boss?
I suppose you could call me that. Well, can I help you?
Well, see, ma'am, I'm a federal officer, and I heard that there was a man around town today that was trying to pass some counterfeit money.
There was?
Well, I don't suppose he talked to you, did he?
Well, I don't know. Well, quite a few men talk to me.
I'll bet they do. Well, he didn't try to pass any money off on you, did he?
No.
Oh. Well, I guess that's about all there is, but I may have to come back here later to check on things.
That's quite all right. You can come back anytime you like.
I can? Yeah, that's swell of you. Thanks a lot. I'll see you. Bye.
We're going to find Miss Shannon.
Upstairs, first door on the right.
What do you have, partner?
Mind your own business.
Come in. Oh, it's you. Close the door.
Me to come back.
That's right.
Why, you don't even know my name, Miss Shannon.
I don't care what your name is. I just happen to like your looks.
Oh, you're an artist. Do you mind if I look at your...
Wait, will you wait right over here? The light's perfect. I'm going to paint you. I hope I can catch this.
I think you could find a better subject, ma'am.
I don't know. Will you put on your hat? I think you're just about right.
Well, I've been shot at, slugged, and cussed. But it's the first time I've ever been painted.
Bravo! Stony Crockett, my old pal. Why, I'm delighted to see you.
Well, I can't say the same. But what are you up to now?
Stoney, my boy, you're gazing at a legitimate traveling man.
Yeah?
Yes, sir. I'm selling a new kind of chemical clear-all for water and so forth.
A chemical clear-all?
It removes bunions, destroys warts, and is a sure cure for dandruff.
Dandruff, huh? You know, I've been having a little trouble with my dandruff lately. You think it'll help it?
Don't see any dulling dandruff there, do you?
Put it back, you're blinding me.
And not only that, but my clear-all purifies water, clears up boils, and eases neurotic pains.
Now, wait a minute. You're going too fast. Tell me, how does it purify water?
It makes all water pure and crystal clear. And Stoney, any man that gets around as much as you do should buy this in 100-pound lots.
Yeah, that's a very good idea. We ought to try it. Here's some water. Go ahead, try it out in there.
Well, I was only talking about regular water.
It's regular water. It's wet. Go ahead, try it.
Well, all right. Don't say.
Come on, put some in. Purifies it all right. It boils it, but who's going to get that poor guy's horse?
Well, I don't know. I guess you'll just have to walk out and bring him back, Stoney.
Yeah, I guess you're right, except I'm not doing the walking. You are.
Oh, no, Sonny, not that again. Now, look, I'm getting sick and tired of you running me out of every town I get settled in. And what's more, I ain't going to leave here till I get good and ready. Be seeing you! Don't!
Something wrong?
Nothing serious, just a couple of boys having some fun. Hey, you're quite an artist.
I guess that's enough for today. Well, when are you going to start working for me?
Well, that's what I wanted to talk to you about, Miss Shannon. Fortell made me a better offer.
Oh? You going to take it?
Well, I don't know. He asked me to drop by and have a talk with him.
And what am I supposed to do while you're making the big decision?
Well, I could always come back and pose for you.
Oh, you could. What makes you think I'm so interested?
Well, you want to finish the painting, don't you?
Might. I might not. If you're smart, you'll work for me.
Why?
Because working for Bartell, you could get in trouble.
If I was afraid of trouble, Miss Shannon, I wouldn't be here.
Do you think I'm trouble?
Plenty.
Nice trouble.
I'll let you know about that later. Bye.
I've been wondering when you were going to show up.
I mean, it's this job you're talking about.
We've been tipped off there's a federal man in town. Is he here because of you?
Not that I know, huh?
Well, I'm about to ride out on a deal. I'd like to know that he's not going to follow me.
You want me to be sure that he doesn't, is that it?
You catch on fast.
When are you leaving?
Right now. If I make the deal, I'll cut you in. How about it?
Count me in.
I'll see you later.
You know this man, Bartell?
I've seen him around.
I think he's our man. I'm going to find out from Miss Shannon all about him.
Leave her out of this.
Why? If we can crack this case, we... Hey, wait a minute. You're not sweet on Shannon, are you?
You never met anyone like her, did you?
No, I can't see that.
Well, just leave her out of this so I can crack this case.
Will you, gun quick?
All right, get your hands up. What's going on here? I've been looking for this man for a long time. Just leave us alone.
You have, huh?
Yeah. Drop the gun. We don't like federal lawmen around here. We've had orders to take good care of you. Take him out of here. You know what to do.
Don't mind if I go along, do you?
Why not? You're working for Bartell, ain't you?
Thanks. All right, get moving.
All right, mount up.
Shoulder. shoulder.
Listen, there's no doctor here. Bring him in my office. I'll take care of him.
Thanks.
Yeah, he ought to be here any minute. You ride out and tell him to come back fast.
All right.
Here.
Yeah, one of these towels.
Went clear on through. I didn't touch the bone.
Said that I'll be all right.
I understand Bartell and Joe are going to be waiting for me when I leave.
Well, Chuck just said Joe to be down near the livery. Didn't say where Bartell was.
Well, I guess I'll find out soon enough. Say, Shannon, who told Joe to kill Stoney?
Hey, wait a minute, Pat. You said you weren't going to drag her into this.
How about it, Shannon? Who told Joe to kill Stoney?
Bartell, I suppose. Why, wouldn't he be the one?
It couldn't have been Bartell. He hired me to take care of Stoney. Then he left town and didn't see anyone else.
Why do you keep talking like this? You've got nothing on me.
Oh, you're way off, Pat. Now, why don't you lay off of her?
You're behind this whole thing, aren't you, Shannon?
What?
This gang doesn't have a king and has a queen. Isn't that right, Shannon?
I don't know why you keep talking this way. You've got nothing on me. You can't prove anything. Why talk like this?
Yeah, Pat, you're all wrong. At least give her a chance to explain.
I'll tell you why I keep talking like this. In case you didn't know it, Stoney, Shannon's been painting my picture. I want you to notice the blue tone.
So?
She wasn't using any blue paint. That blue boy look sort of bothered me, and it still bothers me. So I'm going to find out what's behind it. We'll take these old rags, a little of this turpentine. We'll see what happens.
Pat! Don't! You'll ruin my work.
Watch this, Stoney. Keep your eyes on it. See? There's a painting of our latest revenue stamp. The one that's just been issued.
Hey, Pat, you're going too fast for me. I don't get it.
No? But Shannon does, don't you, Shannon? She'd have made copies from this and flooded the country with a lot of phony revenue stamps.
All right, but you're not doing anything about it. Please, don't make a move.
You still like this woman, Stoney?
Same as he did before. I love him. He's in love with me.
I've got even money to say that that's a lie, either way.
Stoney's sticking with me. Aren't you, Stoney?
The only thing I'm sticking with is this.
Oh.
All right, hold it. I'm in no mood to wrestle.
We're arresting you, Shannon, for conspiracy and fraud against the United States government. Other charges will be noted later. And because we consider you dangerous, we'll keep you locked up. Keep an eye on her, Stoney.
You bet I will, Pat.
Keep Bartell waiting.
Well, what if you don't come back?
You know what to do.
You bet I do. Good luck.
Thanks. When he's moving. I was banking on that.
We moving out?
We're moving out. After you, Miss Shannon.